Good afternoon to everyone. Today I am going to present a paper on clinical patterns and phenomenographic analysis of steroid modified tinea, a cross-sectional study. There was no conflict of interest. Coming to the introduction, tinea incognita or steroid modified tinea is a dermatophytic infection with a clinical presentation that is modified due to previous treatment with topical or systemic steroids. We all know the classical tinea lesions are annular with central clearing and erythematous scaling with advancing edge. With the use of these combination creams containing potent steroids, the clinical pattern of tinea lesions are obscuring and presenting as an eczematous variant. Our aim of the study is to evaluate the various clinical manifestations, risk patterns, and phenomenographic analysis of the steroid-modified tinea. Coming to the materials and method, this was a cross-sectional observational study carried out on patients attending the dermatology outpatient department for a period of 6 months, that is August 2019 to February 2020. Our study suspected case of tinea incognito, and the patients are evaluated with the help of pre-designed proforma that includes complete history regarding the type of combination, steroid creams, their formulation, duration, and the frequency of application, and complete clinical examination was done to evaluate the various clinical patterns and to note the adverse effects of steroids. Phenomenographic analysis used in the studies to evaluate the steroid abuse in the patients. Phenomenographic analysis is a qualitative study in which the patient's own words or utterances are recorded regarding the understanding of that particular phenomenon. In this study, we used this analysis to know the information regarding the advice to use the steroid creams for the tinea infection. Coming to the results in our study, out of 60 patients, 40% are females and 60% are males. Patients were hostlers and 24 from agriculture occupation and 24 had a history of sharing clothes. And 8 patients have a history of similar complaints in the family. Coming to the different combinations used by the patients in our study, clobetasol, propionate, and miconazole and gentamicin combination, betamethasone, dipropionate, and salicylic acid combination, clobetasol, gentamicin, hydroxyquinolone, and tolfenate and clotrimazole combination, ketoconazole, beclomethasone, dipropionate combination, and itraconazole and ofloxacin and clobetasol combination, clobetasol and miconazole, nitrate and zinc sulfate combination. Coming to the clinical patterns of the post-steroid use, majority of the patients were found to have tinea corporis 40%, followed by the tinea cruris 15%, and tinea facie 3%. 10% patients who used steroid creams for more than 12 weeks developed atypical presentation in a disseminated manner with eczematous lesions associated with erythematous striae. Pseudo-imbricata and pustular lesions were found in 22 and 10% patients respectively. Coming to the phenomenographic analysis, 36% patient had skin lesions with itching and went to pharmacy and was prescribed a tube which was referred by the pharmacist as only medicine for skin problem. 8 patients sought the advice of relatives who had similar complaints and used the combination cream suggested by them. 19 patients hailing from the rural background were prescribed the combination cream by the local RMPs. Whereas the 19% predominantly with the complaint of itching went to the general practitioner and steroid creams for advice. These are the clinical photographs which were recorded in our study. In the first picture, we can see the multiple rings of tinea pseudo-imbricata. In the second picture, we can see the multiple erythematous lesions which are studded with the pustules. In the third picture, we can see the tinea facie. She is also developing the multiple rings and pseudo-imbricata-like fashion. In the second picture, where you can see the pseudo-imbricata lesions on the lower thigh. This is a patient who uses the steroid cream for more than clobetasol combination steroid cream for more than 3 months. He developed erythematous striae. In this case, we did biopsy, and where we found the fungal elements are only in the present in the stratum corneum. In this case, we found the fungal elements in the deep dermis and in the hair follicle. These are the various clinical photographs, various medications used by the patients. Coming to the discussion, there was increase in the incidence of recalcitrant dermatophytosis due to the misuse of potent topical steroid, mainly by the non-medical people like pharmacists. The commonest formulation we found in the study was a combination of 5 medicines, that is clobetasol, gentamicin, clotrimazole, flyoquinolone, and tolfenate, followed by the clobetasol and miconazole combination. The duration of dermatophytic infection was higher in people who used these combination creams, and the lesions are non-scaly, diffuse, and sometimes associated with pustules. Phenomenographic analysis, which was used by Som Chitendra et al., help us to understand where many social and environmental factors are involved in the steroid misuse. Coming to the conclusion, our study reinforces high prevalence in the use of different combination steroid creams for the dermatophyte and the over and easy availability and over the counter availability of this combination of the drugs. Phenomenographic analysis in the form of patient won't go help us to get insight of why he was using this combination creams. It's high time for the enforcement of stringent laws against the production of this combination steroid cream. Even though the study sample is small for the generalization of the findings, this study gave us the opportunity to counsel the patients about the steroid misuse and take forward the IADVL theme of fight the topical steroid misuse. Thank you. These are my references. This is the team IADVL to fight against the topical steroid misuse. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Suman.